GM, and welcome to another episode of The Rollup. Today is the alpha mainnet launch of Gravity, and we speak with co-founder and CEO Harry Zhang about why he decided to launch Gravity, which is an app chain built on the Arbitrum Nitro stack for Galxe, the social questing platform. And we talk through all of the motivations and technical specs for Gravity today. We speak about the execution environment, RETH, why they're using Arbitrum Nitro, and why they're using Eigenlayer restaked ETH, along with their own G token, which is the token for Gravity and Galxe, as economic security for Gravity. We talk through the consensus mechanism and why Gravity is a solver-centric chain that solves a lot of intents and ZK proofs for the chains and applications that are built on top of Gravity. All of this and more in today's episode. Stay tuned. First, a word from our sponsors.
Mantle is a layer 2 blockchain with one of the biggest on-chain treasuries in all of crypto, and they had a 100-day campaign called Metamorphosis Live Now. What this is a campaign for their liquid staked ETH token, METH, as well as their upcoming liquid restaking token, CMETH, where you can utilize this token on the Mantle network in a variety of different apps, some of your favorite restaking protocols and DeFi protocols, and earn yields in the form of powder, which will eventually be turning into a governance token. Mantle's been around for a while. We like them because they use their own form of EigenDA. They have a good ecosystem and they're growing. So check out this 100-day Metamorphosis campaign and hope you guys enjoy the rest of this video.
What's going on, guys? Welcome back to The Rollup. Today we have Harry from Galxe, and we're going to be talking about the new app chain that just went live on mainnet. Out of Galxe. This one is called Gravity. Also helping to solve chain abstraction. Harry, I think like pretty much everyone in the Web3 space has heard of Galxe, probably done a quest or two on there. And now you guys are going into the app chain route. So I'd love to talk about the app chain thesis, why you guys, maybe introduce yourself, and then we'll talk about why Galxe chose to launch an app chain.
Yeah, thank you, Robbie, for inviting me here.
Yeah, so my name is Harry. I'm the co-founder for Galxe and also Gravity.
So most of you probably know Galxe. We started with a questing platform, and right now we're really turning Galxe into your Web3 super app, helping you to do everything in Web3. Not only helping users to find the next big early stage projects, we also help users to do better research and trading through all of our AI co-pilots. We also provide users with a savings product that enable them to do like easier yield earning through different chains while having better access to liquidity to their savings. So today we have more than 25 million users interacting with us. We are probably one of the largest on-chain applications. So we just launched Gravity Alpha Mainnet today. So happy to talk more about both Gravity and Galxe.
Let's jump right into Gravity. I'm very curious, you know, why did you guys choose to go from like, you know, this website and then actually deploy things on chain? Like, what is the tech stack? Did you choose OP stack, Arbitrum Orbit, or something different? You know, why did you choose to architect Gravity in the way that you did?
We built Gravity basically to trying to solve Galxe's own need. Galxe today, I think we integrate with more than 35 different chains. And it's really a hassle for users to explore different projects on Galxe. If you have done quests on Galxe, you probably would know that you need to switch network all the time, bridge gas tokens everywhere. It's really not a good user experience when you're facing 35 plus different chains. So we essentially want to build Gravity in order to help Galxe and some other application in the space to onboard more users into Web3 by solving chain abstraction. So I think chain fragmentation is a huge issue for mass adoption, and it's going to be impossible to onboard the next billion users while requiring them to learn about all these different chains, needing to bridge assets and get gas tokens, right? So Gravity is a layer one that designed for mass adoption and an omni-chain future. We just launched Gravity Alpha Mainnet. It's not a layer one yet. It's still a layer two, which
serves as a testing ground for chain abstraction. It also serves as this app chain for Galxe itself. So super excited that we launched Gravity Alpha Mainnet today. We already have 50 plus applications either deployed or ready to deploy. We've already integrated most of the Galxe ecosystem product suites. So we're expecting somewhere around 40 million transactions in the first month. So making us probably one of the top five chains by user activity.
It's very cool. And yeah, you guys have had like tons of traction when it comes to like the social quests that I think a lot of projects, you know, when, especially during the points program, the points meta, you know, Galxe was like really at the core of that. And now transitioning more into this app chain thesis, you guys are going to have an on-chain home for a lot of that activity. And so I think it makes a lot of sense. Also, you guys are fully EVM. And so I'm curious, like, why did you guys choose to go with the EVM route? You know, when you see Move VM, you see all of these next-gen VMs, even Solana VM, settling to Ethereum in some cases. Why did you guys choose stick with the EVM?
Yeah, so I think we are still seeing most applications that are building with EVM, including ourselves. So most of the tech or the smart contracts that we build ourselves for the points program, for NFT campaigns, for reward campaigns, raffle campaigns, we still use EVM as the base hub. And we ourselves still see most tractions from our users through the EVM networks that we integrate, which means we are working with most of the EVM ecosystem partners, at least for now. We are seeing an increase in the Move ecosystem and increase in the Solana ecosystem, but still most activities coming from EVM ecosystem. So we want our partners to be able to seamlessly deploy and use Gravity as their new hub. Which is why we chose the EVM tech stack, and then just to answer your previous question as well. So when we first started to build Gravity, layer two was the first option that came up. Layer two has very fast throughput. We don't need to do too much to worry about security because all assets are secured by the ETH validator on mainnet. However, because we are trying to solve for chain abstraction, one of the biggest flaws for using layer two in the longer term is that it doesn't have a very fast finality. So because we need to solve cross-chain communication, Gravity essentially need to become this intent settlement chain. So if we are settling intent, that requires users to wait 7 days in order for it to settle on the main chain, then it doesn't really make sense, right? So we really want fast finality, which is why we do want to go with layer one in the longer term. And with fast finality, it's not enough. We also need high throughput. We also need a good security parameters to secure assets. So the tech stack that we essentially chose for Gravity is that we integrate the fastest execution layer, RETH, and we also use the consensus algorithm Jotion along with the EVM execution environment so that we provide a very high throughput and near instant finality for our users. We also use restaking protocol. We work with restaking protocols like Babylon and Eigenlayer so that we can collaboratively secure the network with G token alongside with some of the other assets like ETH and Bitcoin as well.
Amazing. I mean, since you mentioned it, like, tell us more about G token. Is this like, this is going to be like the proof of stake token in the network? It's also, I take it, going to be maybe a governance token, an incentive token. You know, could you explain a little bit more about the utility of G token?
Yeah, so G token is basically going to be this one token that serves two different ecosystems. So one ecosystem is Gravity, the other ecosystem is Galxe. So for Gravity, G token is going to be the gas token. It's going to be the proof of stake token that's securing the network. It's also going to be the governance token. For Galxe, other than being the governance token for Galxe protocol as well, it's also going to be the utility token. So it's going to be the payment token that users need to use when they do payments on Galxe websites. Projects also needs to stake G in order to open up space and launch quests.
We also have a G-staking program on Galxe as well, so that a lot of our partners will issue, and they already did issue some exclusive rewards for our G-token stakers. So for example, Arbitrum, Polyhydra, and Jambo, right? Jambo is the phone company that airdropped free phones towards our G-token stakers. So yeah, so G-token is going to be this utility token, governance token, native token for both Gravity and Galxe.
Awesome. And like, you know, for our audience, I think they're very hungry to get their hands on some G-token. For anyone who, you know, is listening to this now, what is, you know, some, what's a good way for them to get involved so that they can start to earn some G?
Yeah, so G-Token was actually migrated from GAL token that was launched on Binance and Uniswap, Coinbase, and all of these large centralized exchanges 2 years ago, I think. G-Token right now is already available on basically all the major centralized exchanges as well as decentralized exchanges. So you can find G-Token on Coinbase, Upbit, Binance, OKX, you name it. And yeah, on centralized exchanges, I think the best liquidity is on Uniswap. And yeah, it's very easy to get some G token. And you can also go to Galxe website to stake G, and you can then start to earn reward. We have a lot of exclusive airdrop coming up for G token stakers.
Awesome. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. The staking on the website, also purchasing it, it's going to be a great way to buy it through centralized or decentralized exchanges. I think maybe to rephrase my question a little bit is, you know, with all of this new activity that's coming to Gravity, some of these applications that you mentioned are coming to mainnet. Is there maybe a grant program or an incentive campaign that some of these applications are running where, you know, they're incentivizing some more activity on their application with G tokens? Is there any plans for that, or is there any distribution or re-incentivization of the applications on the network?
Yeah, so we are currently not running any large-scale incentive plans within Galxe or within Gravity with G-Token. So I guess the very short-term goal for Gravity is that we want to integrate all the Galxe ecosystem products because we have the use cases, we have the users. We want to integrate all of the existing Galxe products and bring on our existing user base to Gravity and demonstrate and showcase Galxe as one of this omni-chain application that's powered by Gravity. So yeah, so that's going to be the first step. We've already done most of that, and we are aiming to complete all the migrations for the Galxe suite, product suites, probably by end of this year. And maybe going into next year, we will be incentivizing more with user activities with G token. And right now we are even though we're not doing any incentive campaigns, there are still a lot of partners that's already deployed on Gravity. So as I mentioned, there are 50 plus projects that's already deployed or in the process of doing stuff on Gravity. So feel free to check out all these amazing partners that work with us.
It's funny. It's actually quite bullish that, you know, you get so much activity, 25 million users without any added incentives. Like, you know, you have all these applications, they have to pay for the user activity because they need users. And you know, you guys are able to get users without the extra incentives. Aave is another one, right? Like, Aave really didn't do very much token emissions or yield farming because they had a great product. They were able to get users organically. They didn't have to distribute any extra incentives. So I think that makes a lot of sense, staying patient. And so kind of zooming back out, thanks for answering all the token questions. I think that's probably it for now. Let's talk a little bit more about the chain abstraction nature of Gravity. You mentioned, you know, Galxe is going to be one of the first omni-chain applications on Gravity. I'm curious about your plan to integrate with the rest of the layer twos that are on the net, in the space now. You know, and you mentioned intent-centric solutions for the chain. What is your vision for integrating the rest of the layer twos, you know, with bridges? Do you guys have an interoperability partner that you're using for transactions on Gravity? And then also for, you know, any bridging or interoperability partners to reach other layer twos and other networks and bring liquidity and users to Gravity.
Yeah, so we're not doing everything ourselves. So we are working with some of these other bridging and communication, crossing communication protocols in order to send messages between chains, bridge assets between chains. So we're working with multiple protocols, including Layer 0, Stellar. We're basically building this intent protocol ourselves, and which is a standard for how to how to settle intent across different chains. But how they transfer the message and how they transfer the assets, we rely on our partners. And essentially, we want Gravity to become the central hub to settle all the intent, so that the user doesn't need to interact directly with all of these different chains like they need to do on Galxe today. They have to switch network and do all of that. We don't want that. Sometimes we don't even want them to know Gravity exists. We just want to provide a user experience to a level that they want to buy an asset. They don't need to worry about which asset that chain is on and how to get asset on that chain through getting tokens or finding like a set DEX on that chain. They just express the intent of, I want to buy this asset, and we help them to fulfill that intent through the infrastructure that powers all these cross-chain intent through Gravity.
Awesome. Yeah, and you guys mentioned like to operate at such a high level of throughput and low latency. You guys mentioned you're using EVM, but it's the Rust-based ETH EVM, it's RETH. And then you guys are also using a consensus network, which I believe is based on Aptos.
Right.
And then this is generating very low latency transactions for very fast finality. I want to double click on the third part, which is the Eigenlayer restaking part of the network. I'm curious, like, you know, how is that going to work in practice with Eigenlayer? They don't have slashing live yet. So, you know, how does, like, can people stake on Eigenlayer right now with ETH and G? And if they do, you know, could they get slashed? What should people keep in mind when they're thinking about staking to the network?
Right. So all of these are not live yet. So for the layer one, it's not live yet. So for the alpha mainnet, it's still layer two, which is like a testing ground for all the intent protocols. But it's more centralized in a way so that we still need people to trust us for solving intent. And once we go live for the layer one next year, all of these would be more decentralized. So to answer your question, when we are still working with Babylon and Eigenlayer to figure out all the details around restaking, but essentially users will be able to stake on Eigenlayer and also on Babylon with their designated assets, and they can choose to use those assets to secure the consensus algorithm on Gravity chain as well. So we're working with both projects actually in developing some of these tech. So it's still in the process, and I don't have too much detail yet, but we will probably have some finalized product and a testnet for our layer one ready next year, Q1 or Q2.
Very cool. Awesome. And you also mentioned like there is a very intent centric vision that you have for Gravity. And with intents, you know, the you know, counterpart to intents is going to be the solver side of that intent network. Are you integrating with other solvers and other solver networks, or are you, you know, a common thing for some of these intent networks is to run their own solver. What does the solver landscape look like on Gravity now? And maybe can people get involved in that as well? Are they able to run their own solvers? Generally, like what does solving look like on Gravity?
Right. So at the current stage, we're still going to be the main player to be the solver. It's still a mostly centralized way, but we want to make it a production level testing ground so that we can be the solver and test out everything ourselves. In the future, probably I think next quarter, we will open up to all other solvers out there. And it doesn't have to be like enterprise level solvers, right? We also welcome all users because there will be an incentive mechanism for everyone to participate in solving intents on the network and get some reward out of it.
Perfect. Okay. That makes a lot of sense. I guess like my next question is like, where do we go from here? You know, today Galxe launched, you know, Gravity, the alpha mainnet. I'm curious, you know, what comes after alpha mainnet? What are like the next stepping stones on the roadmap for you guys to become like a fully fledged and achieve your ultimate vision for Galxe?
Everclear is pioneering the clearing layer. The clearing layer can almost be thought of as splitwise when you go on a trip with friends, but for the blockchain. What I mean by that is when users are sending cross-chain messages, there's oftentimes fillers and solvers who have balances left on different chains that they need to rebalance and reset their positions. This is where Everclear comes in. Everclear is pioneering a collaborative approach to the chain abstraction future, and they are willing to work with interoperability partners, solvers, and other providers in the space to build a interoperable and chain abstraction future. Check out Everclear at everclear.org and welcome back to the Rollup. Covalent is solving the long-term data availability problem where a lot of the data availability providers today in the modular space, when you post data to them, they actually only hold that data for about 12 to 16 days. And then it's basically, they can go into an archive node or oftentimes it's just kind of put away into the abyss. And what Covalent's trying to do is build this long-term data availability solution, which can plug into some of these modular data availability providers and provide this longer-term perpetual data solution. So what we try to think of this as is when you post transaction data onto Celestia or Veil or any of these modular DA solutions or even Ethereum, Covalent is able to provide a long-term data storage and data availability platform for that data after the time period. Blockchains are billboards, not databases, and you know we need these providers in the space to be able to kind of hold on to the long-term data that is provided from these providers and these blockchain state. This is where Covalent comes in. They just had a nice rebrand. Check them out on Twitter as well as the website. Thank you for being here. Hope you enjoy the rest of the show.
Yeah, so I guess for our roadmap, it really comes into twofold. So first, we still is one of the largest applications in this space, and we are still going to improve on that. Right now, still most of the platform is still centered around questing. And we have Alva that I mentioned. I can talk more about Alva. Alva is a very interesting copilot that help users to do better research, do better trading. It basically, the underlying is a LM model that compiles real-time information across the web, whether it's on-chain or off-chain through Discord, Telegram, Twitter, on-chain metrics like smart money movement, people are buying or selling tokens, because it's the information fragmentation in the space for trading and investing is huge, right? So we want to have this LM chatbot to help users to compile all of these different information from different sources through different languages so that we can get rid of information silos for the users. Right now, Alva comes into two different formats. It comes like a chatbot so that you can go on Galxe, chat with Alva, what's trending today, what are the hottest token, what's the social trend, what KOLs are talking about, whether it's bullish or bearish. It also comes in a Chrome plugin version where you can go onto all of these websites like Twitter, and it's going to be supporting other websites like Binance, CoinMarketCap in the future, where when you're scrolling down on any website, when you see a token or a topic that interests you, you can click on that and you get all the information about that project or topic. So that's Alva. We want to help them to do better research and trading and investing. And we also have Smart Savings. Smart Savings is another project, a product that helps users to better do yield earning across different chains. Right now, if you tried yield earning on chain, you probably would know the overall user experience is pretty bad.
it's you have to interact with all of these different chains. And when you go on Pendle or when you go on Ethena, you have to learn about all of these concepts, right? So we essentially want to create a product that user doesn't need to worry about all these complex DeFi transactions. They don't need to worry about which chain that they need to bridge on in order to get the yield. They don't need to worry about rolling over their positions over time. We create this decentralized sort of money market fund-like product that users just need to deposit through any chain of their choice, through any token of their choice, and into this product, and they can start to earn yield. And we also provide a better liquidity solution so that the users can spend their savings everywhere. They can spend their savings through any chain of their choice, in any token of their choice. And this all relies on this intent protocol, this cross-chain, omni-chain capabilities that powers by Gravity. So I'm super excited about bringing Alva and Smart Savings into Galxe platform so that we become this one hub for the users to do everything in Web3. And on the other, on the front, of course, is the Gravity, right? So we mentioned about Gravity already launching Alpha Mainnet, and the next step for Gravity, the infrastructure level, is we make it more decentralized, we make it more higher performance with the actual layer one mainnet launch along with its intent protocol.
Got it. I'm very curious about Alva because there's a lot of decentralized AI hype that's out there in the industry now. And so I'm curious to see this in practice. Basically, what I'm imagining is I can type, swap some USDC or lend some USDC. I can type this into Alva, and then that is like my intent. And then from my perspective, Alva is like the solver, right? If I say swap from, Tether to USDC, it solves that. And what is the connectivity that this AI has on chain? Like, is it plugged into smart contracts? After I submit my intent through something like Alva, what happens on the back end to fulfill my request?
Right. So there are two stages for Alva. So currently Alva is mainly for read access. So by read access, meaning we are compiling information everywhere, helping users or traders to do better informed decisions around whether they need to buy or sell a token. And the second stage is what you mentioned, is Alva will be able to serve users write access. So write access meaning like I want to transfer a token, I want to do some trading, I want to buy some token or sell token, I send a command to Alva and Alva helps me to execute it. So read access, the first stage is already live. You can try that on alva.xyz or on Galxe website. And the second stage, we are still working on, which is going to leverage the intent protocol. So it's basically will do the intent solving in two different stages. So the first stage is converting your command into an intent that matches our format for the intent protocol. So you can say, I want to buy one Bitcoin, and some other users can say, I want to get one Bitcoin on Binance. And LLM model basically translate that into a format that our intent protocol understands on Gravity. And then everything is the same. It's the same for you submitting an intent through LLM. It's the same for other people submitting an intent through a GUI interface, right? So then the intent protocol helps solve the intent, and solvers then come in to get the Bitcoin and send it to you.
Got it. That's fascinating. Yeah, I think there are some other projects that have kind of attempted to do this, but we haven't quite seen it in a way that is truly chain abstracted for like a very easy, seamless experience for the end user. I think this is really, it is the future of making transactions on chain, because you could use Alva, maybe you just use it on a regular just user interface, right? You just use Alva. Maybe you don't even know that you're interacting with blockchain. But meanwhile, right, Underneath Alva,
there's all these solvers that are interacting on chain to get you your assets in you know, the best price, the lowest latency. And that is all happening underneath Alva, like on the, you know, underneath the level of abstraction on the blockchain level. And users don't ever see that.
Right.
Yeah, very, very cool. And then it's using gravity to kind of like settle the intents, right?
Right. I mean that's how it should work, right? So when you watch a YouTube, when you watch a video on YouTube, you don't need to worry about which CDN provider that's providing the bandwidth. So I really think it doesn't really make sense for the users to get exposed to all of these infra level blockchain transactions. They don't need to worry about all of these like gas transactions, gas tokens, different chains should be abstracted away in order to create a better user experience. So hopefully Gravity will become this chain that solves chain fragmentation, that solves chain abstraction, so that we can onboard the next billion users into the space.
Awesome. I think that's really, really cool and a great roadmap for Gravity. And now I'm curious, because you know, Galxe, the platform that, you know, everyone kind of knows and loves, and you know, has, I think everyone would be lying if they said they didn't do like, you know, a couple quests on Galxe. So, you know, now Galxe is just kind of like one app, you know, on Gravity. And so, you know, how are you thinking about Galxe now that you've kind of shifted your attention onto Gravity? Are you, you know, what's kind of the plan for Galxe? Are you team still going to launch quests? You know, what is kind of like the roadmap for Galxe now? That does anything change now that it's on its own app chain, or kind of like what happens to Galxe now?
Yeah, so Galxe is going to continue to grow on its own. So we're still going to focusing on quests. Of course, it's still one of the main growth drivers for the Galxe platform. We have more than, I think, 5,000 partners. We have, I think, somewhere around 50 million transactions last month alone. And we are, that number is steadily growing every single month. And the roadmap for Galxe is just really to become this one hub to help users to do everything. Because to my understanding, most use cases in the crypto space today lies into earning stuff, whether it's about earning reward, whether it's about earning money through trading and investing, whether it's about earning yield through the assets that I already have. So for Galxe, we are basically going to focus on earning for the users or exploring for the users. So it's going to be this one central hub for you to do earning in the crypto space through all of these different kinds of ways. So for Galxe, we while we are still growing the questing platform, while we are still helping and all of these large ecosystem projects launching points program, we also want to help our users to earn better, to explore better in the space through some of these other features that we offer.
Yeah. And although, you know, it's a perfect way for them to do that. You know, one thing that I think like, you know, teams and people have maybe seen on Galxe is and it's everywhere. It's not just on Galxe, but this idea that, you know, of Sybils that are kind of like artificially inflating like their rewards and their earnings relative to like a lot of the other people that are out there. I'm curious because, you know, this is a net negative on the industry. For, you know, people, they kind of like get less rewards, projects end up rewarding people that don't have great intentions. I'm curious, is there any functionality for Sybil protection on Galxe so that teams can kind of use this and they can be assured that their users are like very organic and very real?
That's a very good question. So first of all, I think we have to lay out a concept that we can't prevent Sybil attacks. 100% prevent Sybil attacks. It always comes with a cost. So we can increase the cost of Sybil attacks, but we can never prevent Sybil attacks completely. So for Galxe, we provide a range of different tools for projects to do simple prevention. So for example, we have two different identity products. One is Galxe Passport and one is Galxe Score. So Galxe Passport basically let users to do on-chain verifications. It's basically a KYC process. However, we leverage our identity protocol to store users' information, which is encrypted by their private key. So their information is never shared with anyone without their consent. It's not even shared with us. And once they pass the verification, they can prove that they are a human being because they pass the verification through a third-party vendor. So that's one method that we help projects to prevent cyber attacks. Once they turn it on, user would be required to get a Galxe password in order to participate campaigns and get points. We already have almost 1 million verified users for the Galxe Passport network. So it's probably the largest on-chain network for verification users. And the other product, Galxe Score, is a sort of this credit score-like product that calculates your on-chain reputation score through different metrics that we find. So it can be your on-chain activities, it can be how much asset you have, it can be how early you are in the ecosystem. So basically, we take all of these on-chain and off-chain data and calculate this comprehensive score. So it's less of a serious verification because you don't need to do KYC, you don't need to do facial scan and stuff, but it gives you a relatively a gauge on whether a user is likely to be a bot or not. So we provide these two different products and metrics for projects to use in order to prevent cyber attacks. Of course, we also provide other credential verification as well. So we enable projects to turn on like Bitcoin passport verification. We enable them to turn on some of these other identity protocols. So basically, we aggregate anything that a project may choose from in order to help them to do cyber prevention.
Cartesi is your home for app-specific rollups. At the forefront of developing new tools and platforms that enhance the capabilities of blockchain technology, Cartesi enables applications that are flexible and built to scale. Build on a full Linux environment and use traditional software libraries, but in blockchain development. Go to Cartesi.io, that's Cartesi.io, to learn more about building your own app chain today.
Yeah, and once you have a combination of some of these different identity verification mechanisms, you can almost be assured, like, either, you know, this is a real user, or the Sybil is it costs so much that there is essentially, there's some real organic user that's behind the scenes kind of pulling the strings for that in order to pass the verification. And so I think that makes a ton of sense. You know, being in crypto Web3 is kind of like, I have some mixed feelings about my data when it comes to my wallet. You know, it's like, I don't want there to be like the connection between my on-chain identity and my off-chain identity. But, you know, I can picture a world, maybe it's months or years down the line, and maybe Gravity helps to enable this, where I can sell my data rather than Facebook and Instagram, you know, getting my data for free. They showed me advertisements. I don't get paid for my data, but if my data is attached to my wallet, you know, then I can maybe earn something from that data. And maybe I still get advertisements, but they're not just stealing my data. You know, maybe they have to buy it from me in order to get access from it. They have to pay me in G tokens or ETH or some token, right? So I have mixed feelings. Like, there's benefits to having that on-chain identity with my data, but, you know, there's obviously the privacy elements too. And people can make their own decisions, right? Based on, you know, whatever their preference is.
Yeah, so this is essentially, I don't think many people knows about this, but we actually built this identity or data product in order to help solve the issues that you just mentioned. So for Galxe Quest, what we're essentially doing is we're gathering information about the user, whether it's on-chain or whether it's about your social actions, right? And we store these in our identity protocol. And some of these data are encrypted with your private key so that no one can access these data unless you give the consent to the third party. So we have a ZK powered verification system where, so for example, the passport product, right? You have this data stored within our network and it's encrypted. No one can access it. But when maybe you want to go to a fiat on-ramp or off-ramp provider that's requiring you to do KYC, you don't need to do it again. You can send them a ZK proof showing them that you are not on the sanction list, that you are older than 18 years old. And then they don't need to gather your information again. They just get the proof, verify that, and they can serve you the applications of this gated access, right? So we are actually trying to solve the privacy issues on-chain with this identity and ZK product so that it protects users' privacy.
Yeah, that's one of my favorite things about ZK is like, I can prove that I'm above 18, but you don't need my birthday. You know, like
right.
I can prove that I'm a citizen of a country, but you don't need my social security number. Like there's all kinds of things that can be proven without actually giving away the information. And that's the power of ZK. Very, very cool. So I mean, this has been great. I think we went, you know, very deep on both the technology as well as kind of the high level vision for Galxe as well as Gravity. Congrats on Mainnet.
Thank you.
I think like my last question here is like, you know, there's lots of apps that are launching. Can you mention, you know, some of your favorite apps or maybe just not your favorite, but like, you know, a few apps that our audience can go and try on Gravity?
Well, I guess there's one app. This is actually the partner that we worked with for the smart savings feature. It's called Latch. It's not 100% deployed on Gravity yet, but it's going to leverage Gravity's intent protocol and also cross-chain capabilities in order to help users to do better yield earning in the space. And yeah, so I think over the past couple of years, we've really seen a increase or the space getting more sophisticated in providing better, relatively risk-free, low-risk, and delta-neutral yield-earning opportunities for users. But we still yet to see a good user interface enabling an aggregation of all these yield products. So Latch does exactly that. And Latch also help users to have a liquidity solution so that you don't need to wait 7 days or 14 days in order to get your asset back, right? Right now, if you wait 7 or 14 days in order to get asset back, wanting to buy a meme coin, that meme coin is probably already dead. So yeah, so Latch is super cool in terms of providing you the capability of aggregating yield across different chains, having a good user experience, having a good liquidity solution. So yeah, feel free to check Latch out. Yeah.
DeFi is making a comeback. It's awesome.
Right. Right.
All right, guys. Well, everyone go check out Latch. This should be a great way to go to earn some G. Check out Gravity, all of the applications. Harry, thanks so much for coming on and congrats on Mainnet.
Thank you, Robbie. It's got to be here.
Awesome. Oh, and everyone go follow Harry on Twitter. He's a penguin. So we love the penguins.